LoRa is a wireless audio frequency technology that operates in the license-free radio frequency spectrum, and it's a physical layer protocol that uses spread spectrum modulation and supports long-distance communication. You can easily buy LoRa modules and use them for your IoT project. Many companies are making various modules. The most common reason for using this is that, let's say you want to get a sensor value from a remote location and the physical distance between two devices is relatively far, which limits the use of Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. In this case, the sender device with the LoRa module will attach a specific sensor to transmit the current state of the sensor continuously. And the receiver device with the LoRa module will get this value and send this data to the server or store it in another repository. The receiver device is assumed to be in a location with a Wi-Fi connection. If you Google with the keyword LoRa, you will find many articles, source codes, and example projects, and pre-check the fundamental things of LoRa. I'm going to start this project with an application I made. This is a web application to show GPS information on the map. It's already hosted on my GitHub page, so you can try it out if your hardware is ready. This URL is in the video description below. As you might expect, this takes GPS information via LoRa and displays it on map. I'm using the T-Beam SX1262 model. I chose this one because it increases the shield for 18650 battery. You don't have to have the same product as me. You can test it with MCU, LoRa, and the GPS module you currently have. The source code for ESP32 is quite simple. If you look at my code, you can see that it prints out in JSON format. You need to change the value of these fields to your own system. For example, if there is no battery information, set the battery connection to false and set the voltage to 0 with string type. Keep in mind that the type is very important. If the data types are different, the system will not work. The source code for transmitter and receiver devices is very slightly different. Please check my source code, you will know what I'm saying. Also, my source code is based on the SX1262 example source code. I added the getting GPS part and print it out in JSON format. That's it for my device. As you can see in the right corner of the screen, I put the transmitter device on my car dashboard. And as in the left corner of the screen, I connected the receiver device to my MacBook. After connecting the receiver device and selecting Open Serial Port on the left menu, the list of currently available serial ports is displayed. Select your device. If the connection is successful, you will see the following message. The app begins to read the data from JSON string that is output to the receiver after connection. Two chunks of data coming through the receiver device. One is its own GPS information and system information, and the other is the transmitter's one. The right side of the screen shows a brief summary of the incoming packets. This will give you information about the last incoming packet. The currently available menu options are measuring distance between two points, changing GPS time to local time, and packet monitor on and off. When I have a chance, I will try to add more various functions. This app is built with Flutter Web. I prefer to make a front-end with Flutter, so I did this. Also, I think it was an opportunity to test the Web Serial API too. The only web browser that can run this app is the Chromium browser. Currently, it's only available in Google Chrome and Microsoft Edge. What interesting is that it's slow, but it also works on Raspberry Pi 02W. Again, it's slow, but still I'm so happy with this. If I make a Rider web application, it seems to work enough even at Raspberry Pi 02W. Maybe I should try it next time. Today's project ends here. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.